Listen. You good, yeah? Listen. Listen, I'm so glad to be here, man. Shout out to Himanshu Suri, man, for organizing this. I feel like we live in the times of Brexit and the times of Trump, but thank fuck we also live in the times of people like Hima and Aruj and the Kaminas and all you people out here tonight as well, man. Much love. But it still feels like we're living in some sour times, so I'm gonna jump straight in. This is something I wrote 10 years ago, and every fucking year I hope it starts to become irrelevant, but every year it seems like I need to do it more. In these sour times, please allow me to vouch for mine. Bitter taste in my mouth, spit it out with a rhyme. Hey yo, I'm losing my religion to tomorrow's headlines. Guantanamo, sorry bro, nah, nothing, it's fine. And now it's post 7-7, why are they calling it that? They're trying to link it to New York like we're all under attack from the same big bad guy, but it's taking a piss, because the truth is Al-Qaeda doesn't really exist. There ain't no supervillain planning these attacks from some base. The truth is so much scarier and harder to face. See, there's thousands of angry young men that are lost, sidelined in the economy, a marginal cost. They think there's no point in putting ballots up in the box, got no place in the system and no faith in its cogs. There is a target, so they're getting brainwashed by these knobs who say that spilling innocent blood is pleasing to God. Well, it sounds good when you don't see no justice or jobs. The gas bills are piling up, but all the oil's getting robbed. So David's taking out Goliath and his wife and his dog, segregated, castrated, now we see who's on top. So see, it ain't religious faith that's causing these crimes, it's losing faith in democratic free market designs. It's no coincidence the bombers came from ghettos up north, and the way that Bush and Blair talked gave a lost boy a cause. Then double standards get them angered both at home and abroad. There's a monopoly on pens, that's why they forge their own swords. The misguided turn violent, strap themselves up in bombs, but they're still cowards because they ain't here when the backlash is on. So in these sour times, please allow me to vouch for mine. Bitter taste in my mouth, spit it out with a rhyme. Ayo, I'm losing my religion to tomorrow's headlines. Abu Ghraib, sorry mate, nah, nothing is fine. So all the mans that want to say that my religion has to change it, we're stuck in the bygone ages, time to set the vinyl straight. Don't you think it's kind of strange that all this terror outrage, these last gas castaways, these bastards that will blast away, turned up in the last decade when Islam has been the way for millions from back in the day? Instead of thinking that we're crazy, investigate just what it says fast. Help the poor and pray. Go Mecca, be steadfast in faith. That's the basics, that's the base. So how did we get here today? Interpretations always change. Today they're red with rage. Binge hardened up. Desperation's kind of fucked. Makes you use a book of peace as weapons in a ruck. So listen. Terrorism isn't caused by religion or an old school vision of Islam. It's against the Quran, and it's a new innovation caused by mashup situations. That's what makes them turn to arms. The problem is modern, and it's all local factors. Dictatorships, injustices, and wars cause fatwas. So when it's sour times, please allow me to vouch for mine. Bitter taste in my mouth, spit it out with a rhyme. Hey, yo, I'm losing my religion to tomorrow's headlines. But it's fine. Thank you.